So one of the biggest problems in building LLM apps is the whole area of hallucinations. And there are lots of reasons out there for hallucinations, but one of the most frustrating things for users is when they ask your LLM app for a fact, it returns something that is just totally made up. And there are lots of frustrations around that. Can be things like when they're asking for something that's really recent information and the cutoff of the LLM was way before that. It can be things where there just weren't that many examples in the training data set because it's a specific fact on a specific website that's out there. Or it could be things where they're asking for a specific fact that was just updated a couple of days ago. So while people are out there trying to use RAG to sort of fix all of these things, even RAG is going to have problems when its details in wherever you're storing that in a database, it's just totally out of date. Or if someone's asking for a piece of information that you just never had in your database for a variety of different reasons. So one of the best solutions for this is to incorporate a way for your LLM app to be able to use a search engine. Now, the biggest search engine of them all is obviously Google Search. And just in the past couple of weeks or so, the Gemini API team and Google AI Studio have announced that they're now offering grounding with Google Search. So what this basically means is that when you're making calls to either the Gemini 1.5 Pro model or the Gemini 1.5 Flash model, it can ground its answers with a Google search on the back end, so you don't need to do anything with an orchestration framework or anything like that. It can basically just go and get the results for you. And it's obviously going to be as up-to-date as Google's search engine, probably up-to-date to like almost the last minute or last hour kind of thing in here. So in this video, let's look at how this actually works, how you can use it in AI Studio, and how you can get the code working so that you can actually use it in your apps. Now, in this video, I'm going to be looking at the AI Studio version of this. Google Cloud Vertex AI has another version of this that not only lets you be able to do grounding on Google Search, but you can also do grounding on your own documents that are in Google Cloud storage buckets, etc. So if you want to see that one, I'm going to put that one up on my Patreon so you can check it out there. And I'll go through some stuff in more detail there about the whole sort of things around putting this in production as well. All right, let's jump in and have a look in AI Studio how this actually works. Okay, so you can see if we come over to Google AI Studio in here, and I'm just selecting the latest Gemini 1.5 Pro model. And we're going to start off just by doing a query of asking it who won the Nobel Prize for Physics. Now you're going to see that Gemini's cutoff date was way before this was announced. So it's basically going to hallucinate an answer. And we can see that this answer is clearly wrong. So let's come up to compare. And now we've got two versions of the same thing. But in this second one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down and I'm going to turn on grounding. So you can see now we're grounding with Google Search in here. So let me just come up and we can re-edit that. We can rerun that. We'll do the exact same query. And you'll see now we're getting a query that is grounded in Google Search. So now it's giving us the right answer of John Hopfield and Jeffrey Hinton here. And not only that, we can see a few things in here. So we can see the actual sources of where it got this information. So if we wanted to look at those, we can click on those and see those. And we can see actually what did it run a query for. So even though I wrote in this, we can see that it did a search for this. And so while Gemini has given us a nicely formatted answer, we've got these citations that we can click out to actually see the source material if we wanted to do that. So let's jump into code and see how all this works in code. Okay, so if we come over to the docs, we can see that now there's a whole bunch of docs for grounding with Google Search. And we can see that there's a few different ways that we can do this. We're going to basically set a tool, and we can either do this via a string or via a dictionary, which I'll talk about as we go through this. We can also see that they've got an example similar to what I just did in AI Studio, showing the different things that you can display out of this. So these are actually called the Google search suggestions that you're getting here. So you can actually see, okay, what the search suggestion is. And then you'll see that actually is clickable to take the person to Google search. Okay, so if we come over to the notebook, you can see I basically just customized their notebook with a few extra things in there and changed it a little bit. But basically, we need to first install, make sure that we've got the Google Generative AI pipe package in there. We then want to basically just set up. And sure enough, you can see that we can have a look at the models that this will work with. So this will work with both Gemini 1.5 Pro and Gemini 1.5 Flash. And this is the same for AI Studio as it is for Vertex in here. All right, so first off, we've got the simplest sort of thing we can do is where we basically just instantiate the model and we're going to do a call and we're going to leave it to all the default settings. Now, there's a couple of things I want to show you in here. Okay, I've deliberately put some misspellings in there. Rather than call it the Nobel Prize, I've called it the Nobel Priv. So just the kind of thing that you would see users make spelling errors and stuff like that. And what I want you to see is that the Google search will be able to fix that as we go through. Here we're passing in the contents of what we're using the Gemini model, what we're conditioning the output on. So this is the input to the model. And we're also passing in the string for tools, basically telling it to use Google search retrieval in here. Now, if we run this, we should get it running okay in here. If you don't get it okay, one of the things you'll often see is something like a 429 error in here. So if you get that error, basically what that usually means is that you're not using a key that's been enabled for payment. So doing the Google searches is a paid thing. It's, I think currently it's like $35 per 1,000 queries. But because of that, you may need to make sure that you use a key that's got a payment system linked to it. All right, now in this case, I had that. So we've got our response back. So let's look at what the response gave us back. So we can see, sure enough, it got the right thing. And we got the Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to John Hopfield and Geoffrey Hinton. And we got the same thing that we got on the AI Studio console before. One of the cool things, though, that came back in this is that we also got the search suggestions here. So you can see here, I've got basically the search suggestion of who won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 2024. Notice that it fixed up my spelling errors. So this is the thing that I want you to realize, is that it will take what you put as the input, but it will decide, okay, what's the best search related to this? And the way this actually works is that in the background, when we just pass in the string like this, what's going on is that they're actually going to decide whether to do a search or not do a search. So we'll have a look at the dynamic part in a moment, but really there's this classifier at the background that sort of takes your input and then scores it, and then decides based on that score whether it's going to do the search or not, and also what that search should be. If we look in here, we can see these are the sources that it's citing for that information. So if I print those out a little bit nicer, we can see that we've got those sources. So just to show you, if I click on this, you can see that what that takes me to is a Google search for that particular term. So obviously Google wants you to basically give your users the ability to go to Google search in here. The other things, if we click on the sources though, we can see, you know, that, okay, here's the American Institute of Physics where there's an article about congratulating the Nobel Prize winners. If we click on the YouTube link, we can see that it's going to the announcement of the Nobel Prize from the committee that awarded it. And if we click on the third source, you can see we've got an article about the winners again there. It seems that they don't give you the direct URL. It's like a linking URL so that they can track what people actually click through to, etc. But you can see now we've got exactly what we want if we wanted to do any sort of citations or stuff like that. We can also look and see at the grounding supports. So this is basically showing us where it got the information, and we can see the confidence scores for the information that it's giving us here. Okay, so like I mentioned before, at the back of this is basically a classifier that decides to use Google search or not. So if you just pass in a string, you're setting it to all the default formats. And I think that's around 0.7 is where they score that. And if we come in here and look at this, we also have access to a mode called dynamic retrieval. This is basically where we can set the score ourselves. So just to show you an example of this is that, remember, in the default one, I think it's set to 0.7. here we can see that, okay, a prompt like this would only score 0.13, meaning that writing a poem is not something that's probably going to need Google search for that. Even suggest a toy for a two-year-old, probably not going to need a Google search for that. Now, you'd probably find that score would go quite up if you said, suggest a trending toy for a two-year-old for Christmas for 2024 or something. Then it would go up quite high. But we can see the other ones go, you know, right up, even to things like, okay, who won the latest F1 Grand Prix? This is going to be a very high score for using the Google search and basically saying that it requires Google search to generate a good answer in here. So on AI Studio, you can set that yourself. Let's look at how you do this in code. So to do this in code, we basically tell it, just like before, that the tool we want to use is the Google search retrieval, but we then pass in a dictionary for that. And this is just going to tell it the mode, that the mode is going to be dynamic, and that the threshold here we're going to set to 0.5. So if we run that, and it's going to decide whether it needs to use that information to know who is Geoffrey Hinton. And sure enough, we can see it's given an extensive answer back. It's given us the Google search of what it actually did do a search for. And if we look at the citations of where it's actually getting the data, we can see it's getting the data from a whole bunch of different sources, including Wikipedia and stuff in here. So just like before, we could look at everything that we want to see for that. And sure enough, if we look at the answer, we can see that even in the answer about who he is, we can see that it's referring to the 2024 Nobel Prize for Physics in there. Now, if we just pass in a blank dictionary in there, we will get the defaults like we had before. So when you're setting this up, you can either pass in a string or you can pass in the dictionary for Google search retrieval. And if you want the defaults, just put in a blank object in there. All right, if you want to do this in chat, we can do this in basically the chat model as well here. Now, change the model here to be the Flash 002 model, just to show you that this works with Flash just like it works with the Gemini Pro model in here. And you can see that in this case, we're displaying the text that we got back, and we're then displaying the rendered search suggestion that was in here. Just running another couple of examples to just show you this. Again, if we basically add to that by asking, what is the stock price of Google? Sure enough, we get back the text, we get back the search if we want to show that as well. So one of the advantages that the Google Cloud Vertex AI version of this has is that not only can you ground on Google search, but you can also ground on your own documents. If you want to ground on your own documents where you're basically grounding, like making your own automatic RAG and stuff like that, this is something that you can do in Vertex. So I'll put a video of this up on my Patreon where people can actually see this. This is more of a professional kind of feature. And this is something that really allows you just to build really quick, simple kind of RAG solutions that is leveraging Google's ability to do the indexing and do all of that for you. So this is definitely a feature that you want to check out if you're using the Gemini models. I know a lot of you are starting to use the Gemini models, especially the Flash model. I'm hearing that because people are saving so much money and it is so cheap to use the Flash model and also the Flash 8B model. This just gives you an automated search tool that you can add to that to build your LLM apps in here. Anyway, as always, if you found this useful and you want to see more things like this, make sure to click like and subscribe so that you see these videos in your feed. And I'd love to hear from people how you're actually using this. Please comment in the comments below about this. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.